Oh, Papa Flemmy, here I go again.
Good morning, fellow mathematicians. Welcome back to another video. I just saw BlackPenRedPen's video. I'm terribly sorry for the bad lighting, but I wanted to make a little response video on this integral boy right here because it's terribly easy. And I thought that, I don't know, I didn't really like the method that Steve presented. It got sent to him, but maybe I'm giving it a shot. So let's call this integral I. And let's define a new integral. So let I with respect to t be equal to the integral from 0 to 1 of the sine natural log of x times t over natural log of x dt. And well, just like Steve did, I would like to differentiate this integral right here. So that means that I prime with respect to t is just so, using the Leibniz rule for integration link in the description, the special type, we can bring this differential inside and differentiate the sine right here so that we end up with an integral from 0 to 1 of ln of x over ln of x. And you might notice this is going to cancel out to 1 of cosine t times natural log of x dx. And well, now we are left with this integral right here, and it's quite easy to integrate because if you take a look, this cosine right here is nothing but the integral from 0 to 1 of the real part of e to the I times t natural log of x dx. Since those are just real operators, so this real part and this integral, we can interchange them. It's a Banach lattice, so let's do this. This is now the real part of the integral going from 0 to 1 of, and now e to the, and this is the ln of x to the I times t dx. This is just going to evaluate to x to the I times t. Okay, and we know how to integrate this. We are going to end up with the real part of 1 over I times t plus 1 x to the I times t plus 1 from 0 to 1. Well, this thing right here is just going to evaluate to 0, and this one right here, well, this is just going to be a 1. So we end up with the real part of 1 over I times t plus 1, and we can expand this fraction by the complex conjugate, 1 minus I times t over 1 minus I times t. This is going to be, this down here is just the norm, so we are going to end up with the real part of 1 minus I times t over, and this down here is 1 plus t squared. We just want to take the real part, so we end up with 1 over 1 plus t squared. And don't forget, this right here is I prime of t. So what we really want is to get back to I with respect to t. How are we going to manage this? Well, we are going to integrate this with respect to t. So let me get rid of some stuff right here. So that should be enough space. So we are going to end up with an integral. Okay, so let's see. If you take a look, I with respect of t being equal to 1 is equal to our original I, so 1. And if we plug a 0 into here, we end up with an integral over 0, a definite 1. And this is just 0. So this right here, I with respect to t, I prime, integrated. Doing this, we end up with just I in that case. And this is nothing but integral going from 0 to 1 of 1 over 1 plus t squared dt. This right here is exactly the inverse tangent. So this is the inverse tangent from of t from 0 to 1. Inverse tangent of 0 is just 0, and the inverse tangent of 1 is going to evaluate to pi over 4. Thank you guys for watching. Up until the next video, have a flammable day. If you want to support me a bit more, link to my Patreon is in the description. See ya!